Hey, what's happening? It's your boy, the Carolina Philosopher. Yesterday, I put out a video talking about how happy I was that Dave Gettleman was gone, and I stand by that today. I'm still happy. I'm always going to be happy. I'm glad he's gone before he actually got to put his footprint on the team. You know, his handprint, his fingerprints on the team. Because Dave Gettleman is not a good businessman. You know, people are like, oh, good business. No. No, Dave Gettleman is not a good business. Dave Gettleman conducts bad business. You know, for you to cut Steve Smith, a Hall of Famer, somebody who been with the Panthers for his whole career, who, when the Panthers was horrible, he was that bright spot. No matter what the score is, no matter what the record, you know, Steve Smith was going to leave it all on the field. For you to cut that man and not save any money, and matter of fact, you still got to pay that man to play for somewhere else, that's bad business. And for that man, Carolina Panther, Hall of Famer, you know, NFL, Hall of Famer, to find out he's being cut on ESPN is utterly ridiculous. I can't even get it out right. Utterly ridiculous, man. It makes no sense. That's just bad business, man. And I don't understand anybody who can support that decision. So, you know, I'm glad he's just out of there before he can really, you know, put a handprint on the team. Because all Dave Gettleman really has done was benefit off of Matt Hernan's team. Now, yeah, we had a cap situation. But like I said, it's not rocket science to, well, I ain't say that, but it ain't rocket science to fit a cap situation. If you ain't got the money to spend, you ain't got the money to spend. So you gonna go out and you gonna try to get guys on a bargain. Like, yeah, it's some hard work, but it can be done. It ain't like you got money and you can just go crazy, you know what I'm saying? So pretty much he been on a leash. Dave Gettleman's been on a leash, you know what I'm saying? Because you can't drink champagne with beer money. But as soon as we get out of a cap situation and the first free agency that Dave Gettleman go out there, which I agree that he should have pursued him. I agree that he should have pursued Matt Khalil, but Matt Khalil is unproven, and you gave him, like, he been balling out money. That's just ridiculous. That's ridiculous. So we're gonna have to deal with that for a while. Well, hopefully he pans out, you know, playing with his brother and everything. But if he doesn't, we're gonna be dealing. I don't even know how his contract is broken down, but I hope it ain't that much guaranteed money. You know, just in case things don't work out, we need to renegotiate. Because that's really what Dave Gettleman done. But Dave Gettleman has benefited off of the Carolina Panthers team. And he handled people that you supposed to, like Steve Smith, go back to it. When Steve Smith leaves, it's a press conference. You shake his hand, and there should be some tears involved. Maybe not from Dave Gettleman, but you need to get, you don't just blindside Carolina Panthers fans with a move like Steve Smith. But you can blindside me with a move like cutting Dave Gettleman. I like that very much. I love the irony in that little vindication there. That's just a beautiful thing for me. But like, Dave Gettleman hasn't done really nothing special. You know, we had two running backs getting paid starting running back money. We can't afford to do that unless you're gonna run the ball all the time, and we was not able to run the ball all the time. So yeah, you're gonna either have to cut D Will or Stewart. Could have got one of them had to go. I knew one of them had to go, but you couldn't cut them until, because I mean the contract was so good that Matt Hernan gave him, that you couldn't cut him and not take a huge cap hit to where it would really benefit your team. So I'm glad. I mean, that was a no-brainer. That's all I'm saying. That was just a no-brainer. We knew that had to happen, and we knew, like, big money, Charles Johnson was not doing a big money performance. He had to renegotiate or be cut, you know, at a time, and you had to go and find guys on a budget. And I thought, look, let me say this. Mike Mitchell was a great pickup. Kirk Coleman was a great pickup. Ted Ginn was a great pickup. He found some jewels. He found some jewels in it, and he let them go right away and replace some, you know, with the whole, you know, Mike Mitchell and then going to Kirk Coleman. That's pretty impressive. Okay, and that's about it. That's about all I'm going to give Dave Gettleman. But outside of that, he hasn't done anything but benefit off of Matt Hernan's team and made it to where people don't even want to play in Carolina. Only thing people want to even play in Carolina because of the environment that he has created. And it is not like a, and I heard people saying like on the comments, like on Facebook or whatever, saying like, oh, it's like the Patriots way. He's doing business like the Patriots. Like, no, he's not. First of all, don't compare the Patriots to nobody. Patriots have the best, arguably, the best, and I'm going to say, there's no argument to it, really, the best head coach of all time, who happens to be the GM. So, yeah, he get guys to fit his system. And it's a winning system. And, you know, when you go to the Patriots, you're going to win. You know, it wasn't Patriots haven't always been like that. They had to have a winning system for people to buy into. They had to have a winning system for people to buy into. So people are buy into that. People will trade some dollars for a ring. You understand? They'll trade some dollars for a chip. You know what I'm saying? For a ship. You dig what I'm saying? They'll trade some dollars for that. So, you know, there's a lot of people out there want to, you know, get that ring. And the Patriots is a place where you can pick that up. But Carolina hasn't established that perennial success like the Patriots have. Nor do they have one of the best coaches who happens to be the GM. You know what I'm saying? And you don't hear about people finding out they're being cut by the Patriots or traded by the Patriots because from ESPN. You know, that's just not how they do business, man. That's just not how they do business. They try to keep everything in-house, everything quiet, you know, everything real corporate-like. And that's hard to mimic by any team. It's hard to mimic no team can really mimic what the Patriots doing. So please don't be like Gettleman. Put Gettleman on a level with the Patriots. That's just utterly ridiculous. But I got to get up out of here. I'm going to holler at y'all.